Good afternoon, everybody. You are about to watch Deeper Life Bible Church program, the Moment of Transformation. Today, by the grace of the Lord, we shall listen to our pastor, General Superintendent, Pastor W.F. Kumoye. You are going to be blessed. It is my wish that you call your family to come and listen to you as our pastor is blessing you with his holiness message. Be blessed.
Begin this retreat that we have titled Miracle of Calvary, celebrating the miracle of Calvary. Tonight, we're going to look at the word that introduces us to everything we're expecting. The word that you need to take to heart from this very beginning. Miracles, signs, and wonders at his word. When Jesus lived on the face of the earth, those three words characterized his ministry. Miracles, signs, and wonders. Everywhere he went, he touched every life, and he saved the sinners, he healed the sick, he delivered the oppressed. He did what was seemingly impossible, incredible, in the life of everyone that came to him. And that's what he's going to do in your life. And everything, as the Bible summarizes what he did, came under miracles, signs, and wonders. We're looking at Acts of the Apostles chapter 2. Here is the summary of what Christ did at that time, and what he's still able to do today, and what he's willing to do. Acts chapter 2 verse 22. Notice those three words: miracles, signs, wonders. Acts chapter 2 verse 22. Ye men of Israel, hear these words. Jesus of Nazareth, a man approved of God among you by miracles and wonders and signs, which God did by him in the midst of you, as ye yourselves also know. They knew it, we shall know it in Jesus' name. And then after Jesus finished his earthly ministry, he went to the cross. You know the story. We'll tell the story over and over during this retreat, of his crucifixion, of his death, of his burial, of his resurrection, of his ascension to heaven. And now he's seated at the right hand of power on high to pour upon us his spirit, so that the miracles, the signs, and the wonders can continue, and they will continue in our midst. In Hebrews chapter 2, Hebrews chapter 2, you'll see that it wasn't only with the Lord Jesus Christ. He passed it on to those great men of God, the apostles. And through those apostles, they are passed on down to us even today. Hebrews chapter 2, we're looking at verse 4. God also bearing them witness. You notice that word them, not just him. As for him, yes, we know. And Peter told the people on the day of Pentecost, you know it, you saw it. A Christ went about among you, and he manifested miracles, signs, and wonders. But now it's them, not only him. God also bearing them witness, both with signs and wonders and with diverse miracles and the gifts of the Holy Ghost, according to his own will. Well then, it's very clear that what Jesus did at that time in performing those great miracles to meet the needs of men and women and young people, and then doing those wonders, manifesting, demonstrating those signs. Indeed, at that time, the apostles also did, but now in our own time, look at Hebrews chapter 13. Hebrews chapter 13, verse 8. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday and today, tell me the rest, and forever. It's telling us that Christ continues his ministry today. He did it in the past. He did it in the time of the apostles. He's doing it in our own day. He'll continue to do it until he comes again. Because it says, Jesus Christ, the very Son of God, the one who died for you and died for me, the one who was buried, and he rose the third day, and then he rose for justification. It says that same Christ, risen Christ, glorified Christ, the same yesterday, and today, and forever. How then do we catch? How do we receive? How do we experience those miracles? For those who are ministers, how do you minister the miracles? At his word. For those of us who are recipients of his miracle power, how do we receive the miracle? At his word. Let me show you Luke chapter 5. Does he minister to heal the sick, to deliver the oppressed, to get sinners saved, to get all those who are tormented released out of their body, and to have all those who are demon-possessed, attacked, and afflicted, delivered, set free? How do we minister that? At his word. And you're there, brother, sister, young fellow, a boy, a girl, a child. You want to receive the miracle, the signs, and the wonders. How do you receive that? Again, at his word. So, whether we are ministers or we are the recipients of his miracle, whether we are giving it out or we are receiving it, whether we are experiencing it or we are touching other people to experience the mighty power of the Almighty God, it is all at his word. Luke chapter 5. Very important, those three words, at his word. At his word. When you hear the word of God, and he tells you to do something, so that his miracle power can come upon your life, and then you say, that looks unreasonable, but at his word, I'm going to do that. That looks tough, difficult. I never thought about that, but at his word, I'm going to do that. I never knew that that will produce a miracle, that is the way to have the miracles and the signs and the wonders. But at his word, keep that in your mind. And when the enemy will say, do you think you ought to do that? Once we read it in the word, and you find at his word, you say, that is the thing to do. Look now, Luke chapter 5. I'm reading there from verse 3. And he entered into one of the ships, which was Simon's ship, and prayed him that he would thrust out a little from the land. And he sat down and taught the people out of the ship. In verse 4, now when he had left speaking, he said unto Simon, the Lord will be talking to you during this retreat. He'll say the appropriate word, the miracle working word, the soul saving word, the life energizing word. He'll speak that to you. And as he speaks that, you catch that word, receive that word, live by that word, and say at your word. Look at that verse 4. Now, when he had left speaking, he said unto Simon, launch out into the deep and let down your nets for a draught. Launch out into the deep and cast your nets, let down your nets for a draught. Look at this in verse 5. And Simon answering said unto him, Master, I've done that before. We tried that before. It's like there is no fish in the sea. It's like there is nothing at all to catch over here. We've been doing this over and over, and we got nothing. Look at that verse 5. Simon answering said unto him, Master, we have toiled all the night and have taken nothing. Now it's getting ready for a miracle. You are getting ready for a miracle. We've done that all the night and we're taking nothing. We prayed that kind of prayer before and we got nothing. We did that kind of thing before, we got nothing. We went that same route before, we got nothing. And we try to emulate and to copy other people that did this and did this and did that before, and we got nothing. But look at what follows there. It says, nevertheless, that's the point, that's the turning point in your life. I felt that before, but nevertheless. I said that before, but nevertheless. I prayed like that before, but nevertheless. I came to the retreat before, and I didn't get what I wanted, but nevertheless. That is the turning point in your life, where you can say, I'm forgetting the past. I'm burying the past. All the failures of the past and the defeat of the past, all the impossibilities of the past, I don't want to think about that. Nevertheless, at thy word, I will let down the net. That's the secret of celebrating the miracle of Calvary. That's the secret of having your soul saved, having your body healed, having your mind set free, having prosperity in your life, having everything the Lord has promised you. Nevertheless, at thy word I will. Nevertheless, at thy word I will. That's why we're talking to you today on miracles, signs, and wonders at his word. Three things we're going to look at. Number one, the supernatural power in his word. When the Lord sends out the word, he sends out that word with power. And the word you are hearing, the words of the Lord, the words of Christ that you are hearing at this retreat, even from now on, he sends that out in his power. When he sends out the word of salvation, there's a power to save in that word. He sends out the word of healing. There's power to heal in that word. When he sends out the power to the word to deliver, there's power to deliver in that word. The supernatural power in his word. Number two, the sure promise in his word. The sure promise that nothing can contradict, that nothing can negate, that nothing can reverse, that nothing can cancel. When he sends out the word, there's a promise in that word. And that promise is sure. That promise is certain. That promise cannot be canceled, cannot be erased, cannot be reversed. It is the sure promise in his word. Number three, the sincere practice of his word. Your act on that word. Have you noticed? All those people Jesus performed miracles on, rise up, they rose up. Pick up your bed, they picked up their bed. Do this, they did that. Go to the pool of Siloam and wash. They went and washed and came back seeing. It's a sincere practice of his word. That's what brings the miracle. Number one, the supernatural power. Number two, the sure promise. Number three, the sincere practice of his word. Come back to number one. There's power in the words of Jesus Christ. I said there's power in the words of Jesus Christ. And that word is coming to you now. And as it enters into your body, it enters with power. Enters your heart, it enters with power. Enters your eyes, it enters with power. Enters your ears, it enters with power. Enters every part of you, of your being, it enters with power. And while you are listening, the power is working already. I said the power is working already. Look at the supernatural power in this word. Luke chapter 4. Luke chapter 4. I read from verse 32. Luke chapter 4, verse 32. And they were astonished. That means they were amazed. They were surprised because of the speed at which that word was working. Tonight, you are going to be surprised. The speed at which the word will work. How immediate, how instantaneous the word will work in your life. It will so surprise you. I didn't know I could get saved that easy. I didn't know I could get healed that easy. I didn't know I could get delivered that simple. That's why they were astonished, because it's what came with power. It says in that verse 32, it says, and they were astonished at his doctrine, for his word was with power. His word was with power. Demons heard it, they were cast out. Sicknesses were confronted by that word, those sicknesses were healed. Impossibilities were confronted by that word, the word of Christ, and those impossibilities became possible because of the power in his word. That power is still there. I said that power is still there, and it's going to work in your life even tonight in Jesus' name. Verse 36, and they were all amazed, surprised, astonished, and spake among themselves, saying, what a word is this? For with authority and power he commandeth the unclean spirits, and they do what? They come out. And tonight, when I speak that word against any unclean spirit that has been there for a long time in that individual that is deranged, mentally disturbed, mentally imbalanced, mad, insane, when I speak that word tonight, that mad spirit will come out in Jesus' name. When I speak the word tonight against that epilepsy, the moment I speak that word of Christ, because Christ lives on the inside of me and is living big and strong, and that word is the word of Christ coming out of me tonight, and I speak against that epileptic spirit, is coming out in Jesus' name. It says they were surprised, they were amazed, because his word was his authority and power, and he commandeth unclean spirits and they come out. Look at Hebrews chapter 1 and begin to size up and begin to measure how great, how mighty, how powerful, how irresistible.